DJ Pest is on the beach, ladies and gentlemen.
I really want to hear the story of you. Like, how does this feel for you? Like, 2 years ago, you know, did you picture yourself being here?
Yeah, we knocking and bucking and ready to fight.
The only thing that really hit me, and I knew that it was like I was going to come up, was when I got a call when I was inside the class one day. And it was like, unsafe number and everything. I just sat down. They called me, like, this is the A&R from Columbia Records. So I told my teacher, like, I gotta go. Mm-hmm. And so I was outside talking to him every day. He was like, he heard the song, and he wanted to just chat up more. And I called everybody, but I was telling everybody, because he wasn't the only person that called. It was like, I was getting countless emails from, like, Atlantic, well, people I signed with. Mm-hmm. Who was it? Epic, everybody. They was trying to get a hold of us and everything. And so that was what really had me, like, this song is like really buzzing right now. So that was like the biggest part of just getting them calls from the record labels.
Juju on that beat, Juju on that beat.
How did Juju on the beat happen?
He said he was he really is a dancer. So he already had the dance and the song and everything back when he was younger. So he came to me like early 2015, somewhere around that time, like a year ago. He was like, I got this song, but I don't even know from dances. I mean, I heard like some of this song off of the SoundCloud and everything, but I didn't really think of it. I was just thinking like, somebody want to rap, I'm gonna give them an opportunity. But at the same time, I was still skeptical because like, this is a new artist now, and I'm putting my time and effort into something that I'm not gonna be seen at the proper for me. And so he came over one day, and he was just recording. He recorded the song in one fly. I was sitting there like, what you doing? Like, this song is, it was iffy. I mean, I liked it, but then it was like, I don't know though. That day was so crazy. When we recorded the song, he had just got a call from his friends and everything saying his sister had passed away. So during that whole time, everybody was just sitting there, like, we were just stuck for like 5 minutes, didn't say nothing.
Yeah.
So he was like, forget it, we about to get ready to finish the song. So we finished the song. I wasn't gonna get on the song at first, because I was still thinking, like, dance song, this not my genre. Mm-hmm. But I was like, forget it, because all the songs I do, I try to hit on different races, just be diverse with them. Mm-hmm. And so I ended up doing the song. I told him, like, I need to get this song on my mixtape. So he was like, all right. So he ended up putting the song out, and I ended up putting the song out on my mixtape. And that was, like, in July or something like that. And so when I put the song out, I put it on iTunes and everything. But the mixtape ended up getting taken down because, like, copyrights and all that other stuff.
Other beat?
Yeah, other songs. I had, like, 19 songs on the mixtape. Oh, like, my original stuff and plus more of the songs like remixes and stuff. Mm-hmm. And so I was supposed to just scrap the whole thing and just forget it and just move on to the next project. And so like later on August, I had another song that was buzzing called Neverland. And so I was like, this doing good on Spotify and YouTube, I might as well go ahead and put my mixtape on back on YouTube. Mm-hmm. So I put it on there. So like a week after I put it on there, I seen it start doing like a little buzz and it went from like 1,000 to 10,000. And that's when I told Zay, like, Zay, like, the song kind of moving up there. He was like, yeah, we gonna see and everything. 2 days later, the song shot up to like 100,000. So that's when everybody started calling us. That's when the record labels and everybody started peeking. My dad and I found out. So we ended up getting a call from our management team now. It was like, they were the first people who actually called us. Talking about, we want to get y'all out of here, fly us out next day. But we had already been getting ready for like the music video and everything. And so we already had that stuff on the go. So like that next month, that Monday we flew out there and we thought we was right up there just to meet them and everything. But they didn't tell us like we getting signed the same time we was out there. So that whole week we was working, recording and everything like that. So we was bouncing from Sony, we went to, I think, Republic, then Atlantic. So we was at Atlantic, we wasn't expecting to get signed. We thought we was gonna be out there just for doing other stuff. So we go to Atlantic, we all chilling in the studio. We was in the studio, it was on Thursday, so we was in there for so long. And it was like, hey, y'all come upstairs. So we like, what y'all want?
Mm-hmm.
And so, little you know, we got shouts to Jeff Vine and Mike Cannon, who helped us get signed and everything to Atlanta Records. So everybody's up there, we seen paper, champagne, everything. Everybody in there, we just sitting there like, what's going on? So Jeff was like, y'all ready to get signed and stuff? So he's like, yeah. But mind you, the day before that, we had to go on there and actually do a performance of the Juju song. I did another performance of another song I did. And that, long story short, everybody was in there, I ended up crying, and that energy of the room was just so suspenseful. And that's what also helped us out with getting signed too. But Juju, just a lot of factors that played into it from me and their part and everybody else who contributed to it.
What's the name of the song?
It was Zay part was TZ Anthem, but me being an artist, TZ Anthem was nowhere in the song. So I was listening to the hook like, you're saying Juju, so the song has to be Juju on the beat.
Yeah.
So that's why I put a Juju on it.
Okay.
He wanted to be TZ Anthem for his brother that was locked up.
Oh, okay.
That's where that.
Yeah, you see it online and it has two different names.
Yeah. TZ Anthem is
for him. You hang with Wiz Khalifa videos and you know, like Nicki Minaj videos. How does that feel to be having a song that's in the rankings of those songs? And what were you, number 15 on the Billboard?
Yeah.
Yeah, like,
I was charting in so many different genres, not even just hip hop. The song was doing good everywhere.
Yeah.
And that was just like an amazing feeling because I've been in the music and everything for 5 years mm-hmm. going on. And so to know like this is everything I've been working for. So it wasn't like no big, oh my God, it was like final.
Fine, I feel you.
We
off that. That's old, you know.
You know
how songs don't last.
They
only last longer than dance.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So now you're doing you. What's coming up for you?
For me, I'm more so, I'm into performing and getting like my money and family situated. That's the reason why I got into the music, because of my mama and siblings and all that. That's my soul and the reason why I continue to be in the industry. Because if not, I would just be doing music, just making money from it. But the industry part, it's a lot to come with it. You gotta really want to do this. So for me, it was more so of, like, I gotta do this for my family, but at the same time, I love music. Like, that's my passion. Like, I got other talents, but just performing, like, my first performance, I wasn't even supposed to perform. My dad didn't want me performing. But I had a manager at the time. He was like, forget what your dad's saying, go perform. So, mind you, we was at a university. The show was a buzz. It was only like 10 people that came. He was like, go perform shit. I was like, all
right. Yeah.
Mind you, everybody turned up. I blacked out. I just had for all the monitors, like the feeling of the crowd and everything. That was like a feeling that I wanted to just keep having every time I performed. Mm-hmm. So that's the reason why I said also besides the family, I would keep on doing my music and mm-hmm. stick with it with the industry.
Mm-hmm. I'm a DJ, of course. You know, so I play these on the beat songs a lot. But it never really had a face to it. You know what I'm saying?
That's one thing, that's our biggest problem we have with that, was everybody knew Juju song, but they didn't know who me and Zay was.
Yeah.
That was the only problem we had.
So what do you do to break that?
For me, it's more so just continue doing what we was doing in the beginning. Like, it was, at the beginning, it was just me and Zay. Me, him, my computer, and my grandma's. Mm-hmm. Just me and him, there was no money, it was nothing. It was just pure music and just fun. So that's the reason why Juju became so powerful, because it wasn't no drama behind it or nothing like that. It was purely just two black kids from Detroit having fun.
No magic to it though, right? Like, why do you think the song grew up like it grew up?
Because of the kids. Like, yeah. I say it was probably about like 100 kids who did it. Probably somebody posted on their Instagram or something like that. But the main magic of the song is the kids. Yeah. Like, somebody posted it, see, whatever invite people who didn't have between followers, they saw it, everybody saw like, mommy, I wanna do this. Mm-hmm. And they start talking to the parents, and the parents like, oh, y'all really like this song. That's when everybody started getting attracted to it. And that's the reason why the song is so diverse, ranging from a baby. Like, you see babies doing it all the way to old people, to you got dogs, people who got little dogs doing it, stuff like that. It's like a wild song. This is like the Cupid Shuffle or Disney.
Mm-hmm. Does that affect your writing in the future?
No.
No? No. So you don't, you're not making a song saying I gotta have that same impact?
No. For me, it's more so just making music of who you are, because at the end of the day, nobody can be you. So if you selling yourself, like, can nobody take that away from you?
Yeah. Anybody you wanna work with?
We've been performing with a lot of people. But far as, we ain't really did no big collaboration. I don't know about Zay, but I'd say Eminem, Kalani. I've been rocking with PNB lately. Mm-hmm. Like, he been coming out with some colors. Mm-hmm. G-Eazy, my best performance, the biggest performance we ever had was Indianapolis. It was G-Eazy, Cardi B, Lil Yachty was there, and Big Baby Jam. Big Baby Jam was the actual first celebrity we ever performed with. We was at Summer Song, we brought us out, we performed. The show in Indianapolis, it was 30,000 people in love. So that was our biggest show. Dram, shouts out to Dram. He always brings us out, down to earth person. Much love for him. Mm-hmm.
You've seen a lot of stages, performed at a lot of different events. Is there like a dream venue that, or a dream event that you just can't wait to perform at?
I wouldn't say like a dream venue, but a performance I would want to have with somebody
is Drake, Lil Wayne, and Eminem. Cause I seen when they had the little performance of the Drake versus Lil Wayne, that was crazy. Mm-hmm. Like that whole vibe, the crowd was crazy, they was crazy. Mm-hmm. This having a performance when you know like this is gonna be legendary, that's like the best experience. Like that's something you can't take that away. Like mm-hmm. prime, you can't take that experience away. Okay. I'm about to record this new single called 17 to Live In. This is a summer vibe song. My next single for the summer. And just about to get ready for prom, graduation, and all that stuff.
Yeah, wait. You still in high school?
17. I graduated though. We ended up getting out of the mom and stuff like that.
Okay. You young, man.
Yeah.
Would you do it over again, like the same way, or would you want to, like, did you have other plans? I knew you wanted to be a music artist. Mm-hmm. Did you have other plans, like, go to college, or what was the fallback, or?
Only thing I can say, only thing I would change different is when we first started, how we did our image. Like, because like you said before, like the song didn't have no face behind it. If we would have did like a little more performances and like getting out there more, it probably would have been different and it probably would have lasted longer. Mm-hmm. But besides that, I wouldn't change nothing.
Ain't gonna be no stories about you wanting to be a doctor. No.
Only thing I use, I draw my butt off. Football, that race is bad. Oh, another thing, couldn't study in school. Mm-hmm. School wasn't for me. Mm-hmm. I was always in class, writing, get kicked out for writing, mm-hmm. acting dumb. Mm-hmm. So I was like,
but it's all worked out.
Yeah,
it's perfect. You know what I'm saying? All right.
My social media is Zayion Mccall for everything. YouTube, Instagram, Twitter. Just type in Zayion Mccall. ZayionMccall.
Go, man. Once again, I go by the name of DJ Pest, aka the bad guy. This is Zayion Mccall. We're going.
DJ Pest is on the beach, ladies and gentlemen.